in vermelha, and Marta, you can take it. So what are we tasting?
Hi, I am Marta, Marta Suarez, and I'm working with autochthonous vineyards only for white and red, and mainly with Vital, which is a local grape variety that was almost lost until we found that it was great to make great white wines. Mm-hmm. So this is what we are going to taste now. This is 2019. It's a wine that is vinified in barrel, old oak barrels. Nevertheless, it's now waiting for bottling. So it's put into tank only for bottling. So it is a grape that the vineyards are conducted in gobelet shape.
Yes.
They are very old, in a very old limestone at altitude and nearby the seaside, heading north, so it catches all the ocean winds. And so the grapes are picked by hand.
Yes.
Into small boxes. They are carried directly into the cellar without waiting. And they are immediately emptied into a press, into the press, an old press. And the juice is cleaned only with temperature control. So it ferments after this this first débourbage. The wine is emptied directly into the barrels where it starts fermenting there. It does not ferment in the tank. It ferments directly into the barrels. I only work with barrels of 350 liters, which are perfect for this kind of white wine. They are not too small, not too big, and it's very human-sized barrels so that I can take good care of them and use them old. So, this is a red Castelão. And so I've been learning from 2013 how to make a good red wine, well done, within the profile of the grape variety, Castelão, autochthonous grape variety. So I am a white wine maker, and generally I don't, I close too much the wines. So this red generally takes time to open itself. So maybe it should be consumed 1 year or more after its bottling.
Sure. Which vintage are you talking about?
I'm talking about 2017. It's good to drink now. We are in 2020. So,
sure.
Yes. 1 year after it's made, it's bottled, and then 1 year and a half or 2 years after it's bottled, it's very good to be drinkable.
Where are the vineyards for this wine?
For this wine, they are in the south side of Monte Junto Mountain. So, in fact, I work a mountain. In the north side, I have the whites at 400 meters altitude. And in the south side of the same mountain, at 200 meters altitude, I have the red grapes of Castelão.
Marta, which region are you talking about?
Lisbon. Hi, this is Marta again. We are at my vineyard called Pedra. So it's from here that comes Cuvée Antonio. And as you can see, it is planted in pure limestone soil. And so we are at 400 meters altitude. And the vines are shaped in gobelet. So it means that everything has to be handworked. We are very close to the ocean. By that line in the horizon, we are at 15 kilometers from the ocean, Atlantic. And there you have the top of the mountain, which is one of the oldest mountains in Europe, which is called Monte Junto. So this is Vital.
What is this exactly? What's happening here?
It's happening something very interesting. I cannot say it really in English, but this is marcotage, or in Portuguese, mergulhia, which is an old way of reproducing the vines, which an old vine, you just plunge into the soil.
Okay.
And it creates new roots and create a new vineyard that is a true vineyard. I don't know how to say Vinha Franca. And this is very interesting because generally we don't separate the child from its mother, never. It's believed that it gives protection.
Sure, of course it does.